What's up everyone, Nate Vincent here with FCP Euro, and we are going to be showing you how to change your spark plugs on your 5-cylinder P3 Volvo. This is going to go for this S60 behind me. This is a 2014 model year, but it's going to apply to most 2008 to about 2015 Volvo 5-cylinders. For the spark plug, we are going to be using this Denso OE spark plug. We offer this on the site as well as a genuine Volvo option. For the coil pack, we are going to be installing these Bosch OE coil packs. This is basically the same part as the genuine Volvo part. Volvo recommends replacing the spark plugs and coil packs every 70,000 miles. Now, we recommend here at FCP Euro replacing them every 50,000 miles. And as far as diagnosis goes, if you're getting a stumble or a misfire code, possibly a little bit of a stumble under acceleration or a rough idle, the spark plugs and the coil packs are going to be the first thing you're going to want to replace to remedy that issue. Now, if you have a single cylinder misfire, some people may replace just one spark plug or coil pack. We recommend doing all 5 coil packs and all 5 spark plugs at the same time. Typically, if one is failing, the next one is right behind it. This job is not too extensive. You can usually get it done in a few hours, maybe a morning or an afternoon. And these are the tools that you're going to need to get this job accomplished. First thing is a light duty torque wrench. We're going to torque the spark plugs down to 22 newton meters, so it has to be a small light duty torque wrench. We're also going to need a 1/4 inch and a 3/8 inch drive ratchet. We're going to use the CTA Tools spark plug wrench. It is 16 millimeter. We're also going to use a 10 and an 8 millimeter deep socket, along with an extension and a T30 bit. Now, the last few tools are going to be this 7 millimeter nut driver to get the air intake hose off, and then also a feeler gauge to check the gaps on the spark plug, and a little bit of dielectric grease for the install. So now that we know we need to do this job, let's jump in and get this thing done. All right, so the first step, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to loosen up the clamp here. We're also going to loosen up this clamp here, and then there's a 10 millimeter bolt here and one underneath here, and that's going to allow us to move this cold, fresh air intake off and allow us to get to the engine cover right below it. So using a 7 millimeter, we're going to loosen this up, and then coming over here, now to the 10 millimeter fasteners that hold the pipe on. Now that we've loosened up the two 10 millimeter bolts, the one here and the one here, and we've also loosened up the two 7 millimeter clamps, the one that's right here and right here, we can now pull this fresh air intake up and off the engine to gain access to the engine cover. So first starting right here, just gonna pull it off. And then we're just gonna kind of pry this up a little bit. So now we're gonna be switching over to a T30 socket, just like this. And we're gonna be loosening up these 6 bolts that hold the engine cover down. That's going to allow us to gain access to the coil packs and the spark plugs. All right, so the next cover we're gonna need to remove is the timing cover right here. In order to do that, it's going to be two T30 fasteners, one here and one here, and also an 8 millimeter nut right here. You'll also recommend pulling the oil cap off just to make it a little bit easier to move this thing around. So before we pull this up, we're gonna have to release this hook. So come under here with a screwdriver, and you can just push back. Get that to release, and there's a similar one on the back side of the engine. The last step is to replace the oil cap. Make sure no debris gets down there. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to unplug all the coils. So in order to unplug the coils, we're going to push down on this gray bit right here, and that's going to release the plug and we can pull it back. We're going to do this all the way down through all 5 coils. All right, so now that we have all the coil packs unplugged, we're gonna loosen up the 8 millimeter fastener that holds each of them down, and we'll do this down all 5 as well. So the next step is we're gonna go ahead and remove the 5 spark plugs from the cylinder head. We're gonna be using this CTA Tools socket right here, and that's going to allow us to loosen up the spark plug, but also it's going to pull the spark plug out from the spot that it's received in here. So without further ado, let's jump in and let's get these spark plugs out. So just pushing down, making sure we have a good solid bite on the spark plug, and then just carefully loosening this up. If they get really tight, you can always tighten them back down a little bit and kind of go back and forth with the threads. You want to make sure that you're not damaging the cylinder head threads when you're pulling these out. So there we go. We have the number one spark plug out. You can see it's pretty gray right around the end. I like to take these out and number them so I can inspect them after we do the job. All right, so one of the things you're gonna wanna do is when you get the old spark plugs out, we're going to want to measure the electrode gap on them and verify that that hasn't shifted. We're also gonna wanna know what exactly that gap should be for this engine. And the last thing I like to check is make sure that the cap on the end is the same as the cap on the end of the new spark plug. Some coil packs or spark plug wires actually require you to remove this little threaded cap at the end. And if that is so, obviously the spark plugs coming out will show that. So you just wanna verify that it has the cap or doesn't and make the new spark plugs match. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna check the gap on the old spark plug and the new spark plug. Looking here, you can see I'm measuring basically 30 thousandths with this CTA feeler gauge. So there is not a 30 thousandths gauge in here, but what I can do is I can sum up or add up a couple gauges to get there. So I have a 20 thousandths gauge and I have a 10 thousandths gauge here. By putting those two together and then sandwiching them together, now I have 30 thousandths gap right there. So what I'm gonna do is then take that and check over the electrode. And I can feel that it's snug, but it's not flopping around in there, and that's what you're supposed to feel. It's supposed to be snug, it should be about 30 thousandths, but you shouldn't be able to wiggle it too much or have it kind of snap back and forth. Now setting that aside, I'm gonna grab the new spark plugs and check those as well. So in there, snug, about the same gap. Now that's good. Now, I'm also checking the back to make sure the backs of these spark plugs match. Right here to make sure these two are the same. If they were not, I would have to unthread this off the new spark plug. Now the last thing we're gonna check is we're just gonna go through all of these spark plugs and check the gap. Right here we have one that the gap is a little bit more open. I can feel it kind of snapping back and forth. If you have that issue, what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna just take this electrode very carefully and you're gonna wanna hammer that down or tap the spark plug on something hard, say like this. Very carefully like that, which will bend this electrode down towards the end of the spark plug, and then measure it again and make sure you get that gap down to where it needs to be. So now that we've checked the gaps in the spark plugs and we've also made sure the connection to the coil is correct, we're going to use the same wrench that we took them out with and we're going to go install them. All right, so now to install the spark plug. So now using a torque wrench, we're going to torque these down to 22 newton meters. So the next step is we're gonna go install the coil packs into the cylinder head. Now before we do that, we're gonna take a teeny bit of dielectric grease and we're just gonna put a little dab on each end before we put them down and seal them up against the spark plug. And then we're gonna take the 8mm wrench and we're gonna tighten down the 8mm bolt that holds this into the cylinder head. Basically install, and we're gonna push that down, make sure our orientation's right. It's gonna create a seal up to the cylinder head, just like that. And then we'll take the 8mm and tighten that down. The torque on the 8mm is 10 newton meters, or in this case, as I'm doing it, just snug. You can see I'm just gonna put a little bit of a dab there, about that much. And I'm just gonna kind of work that around just like that. And that's it. All right, so now that we have the coil packs installed, the last step of the job here before we put the engine cover back on and the intake pipe back in is we need to plug in the coil packs. So we're gonna run down the line and we're gonna plug each of them in. All right, so now it's time to button the engine back up. So we're going to put the timing cover on, the main engine cover on, and the intake tube back in. Pretty simple stuff here. It's really just reverse of taking it apart. We're gonna do this in one clean sweep. The key elements here is we wanna make sure that this little L bracket and this little L bracket hook under right here, and the same thing on the backside of the engine to make sure that this holds down over the timing cover. Now taking a T30, tighten these down. So the next and last step is we're going to install the fresh air intake to the turbocharger. What we're going to do is basically slide it in both the hoses right here and here, and then we're going to bolt it in here on the back of the engine cover and here on the side. The one on the side is really hard to see. It's basically buried up underneath there, but by feel you'll be able to feel the bolt going into it. All right, and on. So now we're going to take a 10 millimeter socket on an extension, and we're going to snug this one down behind it. All right, and then we're going to go down without the extension and with feel snug the one on the side of the engine. So the final step is we're going to go ahead and tighten down the clamps using this 7 millimeter flex driver. All right guys, thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful in showing you how to change your spark plugs and your coil packs on your Volvo P3 chassis. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and we'll catch you on the next one. Take it easy.